there I am with you with some problems with the concept volume of cone. Okay, so see here, today's first problem is a semicircular sheet of metal of diameter 28 centimeter is bent into an open conical cup. Find depth and capacity of cup. Okay, so what is the question? See, once again figure is given for this, a semicircular sheet of metal of diameter 28 centimeter. Okay, this diameter is 28 centimeter. Okay, now what is there after this? Is bent into an open conical cup. Is bent into an open conical cup. Okay, so this figure, this semicircular metal sheet will be bent into the open circular cone. Okay, then we have to find out depth and capacity, means volume and depth. Depth means we have to find out height. Okay, so see here, when it will be bent into a open conical cup, that time how the figure will get? See here, this is the radius, the diameter is given 28 centimeter. Okay, diameter is given 28 centimeter. Now when it will be bent, that time this radius will become slant height. This radius will become slant height. This will be slant height. Okay, so that will be same. That is 14 centimeter. Okay, and this circumference of semicircular sheet will be the base of this cone. Conical sheet will be the base of conical sheet. Understood? So from this figure we will get this is 14 centimeter. So slanting height is also 14 centimeter. Understood? And this whatever area from this to this, the distance will be the circumference of this sheet. Understood? So what we will do here, first slant height we have, that is 14 centimeter. Okay, so I want to find out first this radius of this cone. Understood? Here radius is given. Okay, so if I want to find out circumference of this sheet, circumference of this metal sheet, circumference of metal sheet is equals to, how will get? This is the semicircle. Okay, and this side we are not going to consider, only this circumference. Okay, so it will be 2 pi r divided by 2, means it will be pi r. Okay, so pi r, and what is the radius of this? 14. So we will multiply here by pi multiply by 14, so that will be 14 pi. Okay, so this is the circumference of metal sheet. Okay, now we are going to use this. Okay, this distance means circumference of this metal sheet is equals to the base of the cone. Understood? So base of the cone means that is also we are going to consider, this is circumference, so we will consider that 2 pi r is equal to 14 pi. 2 pi r is equal to 14 pi. Got everybody? This distance will be converted into the base of cone. Understood? And base of cone means what? Circumference of the cone. Okay, so circumference of the base is equals to the circumference of sheet. Okay, so that's why we have taken here 2 pi r is equal to 14 pi. Understood? So now here pi, value of pi we can cancel. Okay, so now 2 r is equal to 14. So r is equals to 14 divided by 2. So r is equals to 7 centimeter. So we have radius now. Understood? Radius of this cone. Radius of cone is 7 centimeter. Okay, radius we have, slant height we have. So with the help of this, we can find out height of the cone. Okay, so height will be h, and this is perpendicular. Okay, you know that very well. So with the help of these two things, we can find out height of the cone. Okay, so height of the cone is equal to L square is equal to r square plus h square. L square is equal to slanting height square is equal to radius square plus height square. Okay, so height we don't have, so h square is equal to L square minus r square. Okay, L is slanting height, that is slanting height is 14 centimeter. So that value I am taking here, 14 square minus radius just now we have, that is 7 square. Okay, 7 centimeter square. So h square is equal to a square minus b square, like that we will do 14 plus 7 and 14 minus 7. Okay, so h is equals to what? 14 plus 7 is 21, h square is equal to 21 multiplied by 14 minus 7 is 7. Okay, so 21 multiplied by 7. So 21 we can factorize, 7 threes are 21. So h is equals to 7 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 7. Okay, 7 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 7. Okay, so we can factorize like that. So h square is equals to we can take this 2 times 7 is there, so we can take that outside, 7 root 3, h is equals to 7 root 3. Okay, 7 is 2 times, 7 is in pair, so we can take that outside, and root 3, 3 will be in under square root. Okay, so h is equal to 7 root 3, but we know the value of h is equals to value of root 3. Root 3 is equal to 1.732, so 7 multiply by 1.732, and the product of this will be 12.12. h is equals to 12.12. Okay, see here once again what we have done. Circumference of this sheet is equals to the base of cone. Okay, so that two values we have to compare here. So 2 pi r is equal to 14 pi. Okay, because only half circumference we will consider about metal sheet. So we have taken that is 14 pi. Pi value will be cancelled. 2 r is equal to 14. So r is equal to 7 centimeter. Okay, now we have to find out depth. Depth means what? We have to find out height of this. Okay, so to find out height, we have to use L square is equal to R square plus H square. So two values we have. So that when you will take, that time we will get value of h is equal to 7 root 3, and root 3, the value of root 3 is 1.732. So that we have to put here. When you will find out product, that time height you will get 12.12. Okay, so we have height. Now we have to find out capacity. Capacity means what? Capacity of this is volume of cone. Okay, so capacity, the formula of volume of cone is equals to 1 by 3 pi r square h. Okay, so 1 by 3 multiply by volume of this is pi 22 by 7, the radius we have, that is 7 multiply by 7 into height is, just now we got height is 12.12. Okay, so from this 7 will be cancelled. Okay, so now product of this we need to find out, 22 multiply by 7 into 12.12 divided by 3. Okay, so this product will be this, when you will find out product and you will divide by 3, that time you will get answer 622.16 centimeter cube. Okay, so this is our final answer, and that is the capacity. Capacity means what? Volume of this cone. Okay, so once again see here, just now I have explained you, this is the height of the cone. Okay, with the help of height we have to find out capacity. Capacity means what? Volume of cone, and volume of cone we use formula 1 by 3 pi r square h. Okay, so 1 by 3, value of pi is 22 by 7, r is radius of the cone, that is 7 centimeter, 7 multiply by 7, and height is 12.12. so when you will put here 7 we can cancel, find out product 22 multiply by 7 multiply by 12.12. okay, so by this 3 we can divide here 12.12. okay, so it will be 4.04 multiply by 22 into 7, and you will get the answer 622.16 centimeter cube. Okay, so that is the volume or capacity of this cone. Okay, okay, so our second problem is, a conical tent is 9 meter high and radius of its base is 12 meter. There are two questions. First question is, what is the cost of the canvas required to make it if a square meter canvas costs rupees 10? Okay, so this is the first question. Second question is, how many persons can be accommodated in the tent if each person requires 2 square meter on the ground and 15 meter cube of space to breathe in? Okay, two questions are there. So first we will think about first question. Okay, before that, what is given? See here, a conical tent is 9 meter high and radius of its base is 12 meter. Two things are given. Okay, so conical tent is 9 meter high, means vertical height is given 9 meter high. So this is 9 meter, and what is given? A radius of its base is 12 meter. This is given 12 meter, and this is perpendicular. Okay, so with the help of these two things we can find out slant height. Understood? With the help of these two things we can find out slant height, because what is given here, see, what is the cost of the canvas required to make it if a square meter canvas costs rupees 10. So here for first question, to find out answer of first question, we need to find out pi r l, means what, curved surface area of the cone. Okay, to find out curved surface area, we are using pi r l. L means what? Slanting height. And here slanting height is not given directly, but with the help of these two things we can find out slanting height easily. Okay, so first we will find out that slanting height. So in solution, what is given here? Radius is given 12 meter, and height is given 9 meter. Okay, so with the help of these two things we are going to find out slant height. So L square is equal to under root R square plus H square. Okay, so R is, radius is 12 square plus H square is 9 square. Okay, so 12 square is 144, 12 square is 144 plus 9 square is 81. Okay, so 144 plus 81 is 225. So 225 is the square of 15, or square root of 225 is 15. So L is equals to 15 meter. So we have now slant height. Okay, we have with the help of radius and height we have to find out first slant height. Okay, now the first question, we will move towards the first question, that is what they are asking. What is the cost of the canvas required to make it if a square meter canvas costs rupees 10? Okay, we have to find out cost, but before that we have to find out curved surface area of this cone. Without that we cannot find out cost. Okay, so we need to find out how much material is required. Okay, so first we will find out curved surface area. CSA of cone is equals to pi r l. Okay, so that is pi, value of pi is not given here, so we have to use 22 by 7 multiply by radius. Radius we have, that is 12. Okay, and height, 12 multiply by height is 15 meter. Okay, pi r l, l means the slanting height. Okay, so we are using here 15. Okay, so your answer will be 565.7 meter square. Okay, this is the curved surface area. 500, and when you will multiply this, 22 multiply by 12 multiply by 15 divided by 7, that time you will get 565.7 meter square. So this is the curved surface area. Okay, but this is not our final answer. Okay, so here what they are asking, what is the cost of the canvas required to make it if a square meter canvas costs rupees 10. Okay, so here for this answer we need to multiply by 10, then we will get the cost. Okay, so they are asking cost, total cost is equals to 565.7 multiply by rupees 10. Okay, so when you will multiply by rupees 10, that time you will get 5657. This decimal point will shift. Okay, so your this first answer is 5657. Okay, so what we have done, got it everybody? First, with the help of radius and height we have to find out slanting height, and with the help of slanting height we have to find out curved surface area, but we have to find out total costing. So we multiply by 10, because cost is given. Okay, cost is given per square meter, cost is given rupees 10, and this is the area, curved surface area, so we need to multiply by 10. Okay, now second question is how many persons can be accommodated in the tent if each person requires 2 square meter on the ground. Okay, on the ground they have told us, on the ground, and 15 meter cube of space to breathe in means this inside. Okay, ground, two things we are going to find out here. On the ground means we need to think about ground only. Okay, ground means what? The base is circular, or base of tent is circular. So here we have to find out, first thing we have to find out area of the base, means area of circle. Okay, so area of base is equals to pi r square. Area of base of tent is equal to pi r square. So pi we have 22 by 7 and radius is 12 into 12. Okay, r square is 12 into 12, so that you will get 452.16 meter square. 452.16 meter square. Okay, what we have done, why we are using here area of the base pi r square, because they have told us if each person requires 2 square meter on the ground. On the ground means we are going to think about ground of the tent, and ground is circular. Okay, so here we have to find out this area of the ground. Okay, so that is area of base is pi r square, so 22/7 multiply by 12 multiply by 12, and that product is 452.16 meter square. Okay, but one more thing they have told us, if each person requires 2 square meter. Okay, so how many persons will be there on the ground? Okay, so the maximum persons on the ground will be, how we'll find out, because each person required 2 square meter, and this much space is available, so 2 square meter for each person, so is equal to, we need to divide this by 2, 452.16 divided by 2. Okay, so it will be 2 to the 4, 2 6 are 12, and 08. Okay, so we will consider here 226 number of persons. 0.08 we will not consider, we will consider 226. Getting everybody? So on the ground there are maximum 226 persons will get place. Okay, so this is the half answer. One more thing they have told us, and 15 meter cube of space to breathe in. To breathe in means what? Here. Okay, so we need to find out this whole area. This whole area means what? Volume of the cone. Okay, so we are going to find out now volume of the cone. Volume is equals to 1 by 3 pi r square h. Pi r square h, 1 by 3 into pi r square h. Volume of cone we are going to find out. Okay, but here not necessary to find out each and value once again, because pi r square means what? Area of base we have 452.16. So directly we can replace pi r square by 452.16. okay, and height is 9 meters, so that we can multiply. Understood? So now I'm taking here that 1 by 3 multiply by pi r square h, 452.16 multiply by height is 9. Okay, and unit will come meter cube. Okay, so when you will solve this, that time will get 1356.48. Okay, so 3 3s are 9, you need to multiply here, so you will get 1356.48 meter cube. Okay, so this is the volume. But one more thing they have told us, 15 meter cube of space to breathe in. 15 meter cube space to breathe in means each person will take 15 meter cube. Understood? To breathe in. So we need to divide here by 15. Understood? So here I am going to divide, that is 1356.48 divided by 15, and this answer you will get, 90. Understood? So now 90 and 226, we have two answers, 990 and 226. So which is the smallest number here? 90. So 90 persons can accommodate in that tent, because both the things we need to see. We have to see area also, area of the base as well as area in the space. Means we need to think for breathing also. So if you will think both the things, we will think about both the things, then 90 is the correct answer. Okay, this is only of base and this is with the space. Okay, so 90 is the correct answer. Once again we will put a glance, what was given, radius was given and height was given. With the help of radius and height we have to find out slant height. Why we are finding slant height? Because first question is related to curved surface area of cone. So curved surface area of cone is pi rl, so here we have taken pi rl, so value we got 565.7 meter square. Okay, these calculations you have to do because it will take little time, so directly I am telling you answers here. So 565.7 meter square. Now total cost is rupees 10 per square meter is given, so we have multiplied by here rupees 10, so this is the cost of canvas which is required. Okay. Now second question, they have told us how many persons can be accommodated in the tent if each person required 2 square meter on the ground and 15 meter cube of space to breathe in. Understood. So here we have taken on the ground. So on the ground means the base of the conical tent is circular. So we are finding here area of the base of tent, that is pi r square. Pi is 22/7, the radius is 12 into 12, so we got answer 452.16 meter square, but each person will take 2 meter square place. Okay, so here this area we need to divide by 2. Understood. So 226.08. So we will consider answer 200, because maximum number of persons we are going to find out. So 226 answer we will consider for some time. Now volume, we are going to think about volume because they have told us 15 meter cube of space to breathe in. So we are going to think about volume. Meter cube is given, so we need to think about volume. So 1/3 pi r square h. Again, we are not going to put all the values because pi r square we have 452.16. So that value we will put here. Height is 9, so we will multiply by 9. Then when you will find out product, that time you get 1356.48. And why we are dividing here by 15? Because each person will take 15 meter cube for breathing. So we have divided here by 15. So answer we got 90. Okay. Now correct answer is 90. Why? Because we need to think about place to occupy as well as for breathing. Understood? Both the things we need to see. So our correct answer is 90. So 90 persons can accommodated in that tent. Okay. So answer is 90 persons. Okay. Thank you.